Hi and welcome back to The Shtick. We're in our last segment for this episode and we've got a wonderful young man. His name is Effie Block and he's coming to us via Zoom in St. Kilda. Hi, Effie.
Hi, how are you, Henry? Nice to speak to you again. Baruch Hashem.
That's what they say, which means, what does that mean in English?
That means thank the one above.
Thank the Lord. That's good. Now, you're a rabbi. You're a long line of rabbis. I've met your grandfather on your mother's side. He's from England.
Correct. And I don't know if you've met my grandfather from my father's side. He's Dr. Block from Ontario, from Canada.
That's right. Well, I've had both your parents on the shtick, Sorry Block, and also Shmuley Block. Both of them have been on. Now it's your turn. Because you've set up a little Chabad house in St. Kilda. And I was there yesterday. And it's a sweet little place to start off because St. Kilda, you've already got St. Kilda Shul there. And that's the oldest shul in Melbourne, probably, established. And now we've got the newest one. And what I wanted to talk to you about specifically, when I saw it, I went, wow, you're doing six outdoor public Hanukkah lightings in different parks and spots in St. Kilda.
Correct. So we started off, we saw there was a need in St. Kilda to reach out. There's many Yidden, many Jewish people around the area. And we decided this is the time to start a Jewish center. You try to revive a bit of the St. Kilda, you know, down by Acklin, Fitzroy, etc. And besides about the St. Kilda Road, there's many Jewish businesses. So we started over here. Baruch Hashem, we've found many people. And to really bring people together as one, obviously the lockdown was a bit of a hard gig trying to connect people together. But the main mission that we've found and that we've seen is to really get people to, you know, come together as a community, especially people who not yet have met the Bashert, or they have, but they need to find the next Bashert. That we've seen there's many singles, whether they're young or old, throughout the community that, you know, need to find their companionship, need to find the respective partner. So we've made it our mission to go out there and try to connect people to one another. And as we know, as you know, as a Jewish community center, we want obviously the Jewish people to connect to other Jews and to really come together as one. And this is what we've been focused on. And like you said, we have beautiful six events throughout St. Kilda. And we hope everyone can come down and make it. There'll be a beautiful Hanukkah lighting with latkes, of course, and just a nice ruach, a nice atmosphere. And we're doing it every single night of Hanukkah, besides for Friday and Shabbos. So come down to your local park. If you haven't seen us on Facebook yet, we have all the information over there. And, you know, that's what it's all about, just getting people together as one. And this is what we need, especially after the lockdown. We need connections.
So important. I've actually put up the poster that you have on Facebook. I've put it on my Facebook too to share it because I think you need as many people coming from the local area. St. Kilda is known as a buzzy area, busy happening place. And on the 28th of November, you're having it at the St. Kilda Town Hall in the front there, in the outside.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yes, on the front grass over there, yeah.
Yeah, and then the next night you're doing St. Kilda Botanical Gardens.
Yes, by the playground area, yep.
Fantastic. And then the night after, you're in Alma Park. Which part of Alma Park are you going to be?
So that's also by the playground area. There's a nice little spot over there. It's very important. Hanukkah, there was a big emphasis to spread the light, to spread the light of Hanukkah. And I know it is a bit earlier this year than normal. So Jewish people walking past might be a bit shocked. What's the menorah doing up as they walk past? But that's exactly the point to give the awareness and spread the light of Hanukkah to others.
And then the 1st of December, you're going to be at Elwood Beach just next to the grass.
Yes, yeah, so that's going to be by next to Elwood Bathers. I believe there's a restaurant there on the beach. So on the foreshore area, the grass right by that restaurant, there's going to be a beautiful menorah put up there, and we'll have to secure it from the wind right by the beach, but we'll figure that one out. And yes, we want everyone from around Elwood, that area. You know, I'm sure there'll be many people walking past as they do, taking a walk along the beach, and they'll definitely be able to join in to the festivities.
And then the next night, you're doing O'Donnell Gardens, which is just adjacent to Luna Park.
Correct. I was actually there last night visiting someone around there, and I asked someone, you know, would the menorah be all right, you know, being put up there? So hopefully we'll have no troubles over there, but the menorah will be put up there right by Luna Park, right by Ackland, I think, yes. So it'll be all right.
And then you're going to have two nights off for Shabbos and Saturday. And then on the last night, you're going to be at the Jim Duggan Reserve. Where's that?
So the Jim Duggan Reserve is a small park right next to my house where we live. It's by the Betty Day Center. I don't know if people know about it. It's the Port Phillip Council building. So right over there, there's a nice little park that we go to quite often. And we've met many, many people over there. And we thought it'd be nice just to give a bit of a personal touch to the immediate family or community around the park over there. So that's our locations, and hopefully everything goes off, you know, in a beautiful, beautiful way, and everyone can experience the light of Hanukkah. That's what it's all about.
Yeah. Now, I wanted to also ask you, what time approximately is the lighting for Hanukkah?
So if you look on the flyer, it says 6:30 p.m. for the 7 p.m. lighting. So we're going to have, you know, we're starting the event 6:30. We'll have, you know, food and a bit of music, a bit of a nice atmosphere, people getting together, talking. And then the 7 p.m. we'll be doing the lighting.
Fabulous. Now, I wanted to get your Rebbetzin, your wife, Shana yes. Mushka, who I met Shana. Just yesterday. And she's a dynamo. I think every rabbi I know has a Rebbetzin who is a dynamo. And hello, Shana.
Hi, how are you?
I'm really, really good. I just wanted to get a little bit of a spiel from you about the work that you do, especially in bringing together single people, because I know that's one of the objects. You see a lot of people living by themselves, especially in St. Kilda, little flats, and, you know, they're either single or they're divorced and they're trying to find their beshert. And I just wanted to tell us what beshert means and what you're doing to get people together.
Yes. So we really do meet so many people around here who would love to build a family and they haven't met their match yet. And we are very lucky to have the opportunity to have many of those people by our table during the week and on Friday nights. And we're quite lucky. I feel very privileged and honored to be able to host them at our house. And I would really love for them to be able to meet their matches. And the word bashert does mean a person's match, which was decided by God. So, you know, we believe that every person has a soulmate, which is really the other half of their soul. And the discovery is to find that person. So we hope that, you know, we're all messengers. We're just messengers by God. But we do hope that divine providence will help these people and us to connect everyone together so that they could find their match and reach their dreams, which are, you know, to have that connection and build a beautiful Jewish family.
It's been really difficult during the times of COVID, particularly in the last 18 months. I'm a victim myself because I had to separate from my other half because she works interstate, and we knew that this was going to go on for a long time. So we had a mutual understanding that this wasn't going to work over COVID. We don't know what the future will bring, but I'm single myself, so I'm going to put it out there that if I'm single and I need to mingle. And now that we're open a bit more, I'm going to see if I can start getting out there, or, you know, because I don't believe in this online dating. I just haven't done it and I don't believe in it. I think people need to actually meet in person.
Yeah.
And that's very important. I know that you do a lot of work also in giving people food and giving them a solace, you know, because there are sick people around. So you do all the things that Chabad does, you know, they provide services. And you've got two beautiful children, who I met yesterday. You've got Yitzchok Leb, who's a total cutie, and Chaya Leah, who's even more cute. So I wish you many more children, which I'm sure you will have, but you'll have to move into a bigger house.
I think so. Yeah, I wanted to mention that, you know, as Chabad Shluchim emissaries, we're so lucky and privileged to meet all these people and bring them into our home. But our first and foremost, you know, priority is always our children, and they always, you know, our spouse and our children. You know, we have to have a strong family in order to be able to expand our family, which are, you know, to bring all of these people into our home. So I felt it's, you know, I'm so grateful for my beautiful children, and I'm proud of them too, because they really help us do our mission. You know, when people come over and they're able to enjoy our beautiful children, and they hold them and they play with them and they're cute, you know, I feel that that's a big part of what we do, which is to just be transparent. You know, we are who we are. Our children are part of what we do. They're not just part of what we do. They're such a essential, you know, aspect of bringing people in and seeing transparency. You know, this is who we are, and we're so grateful, you know?
Wonderful. Anyway, it was really great to meet you yesterday, and I wish Effie all the best with your ambitious. I mean, that's a really big shtick you've got going for six nights of Hanukkah lighting.
That's it. We're going all out for Hanukkah.
I'll come down and check you out and do some singing, because there's always songs and dancing going on.
That's it. Exactly, yep. Right.
And I love a latke or two.
100%. And we'll see you more often, Henry.
Absolutely. You're definitely, I'll be coming around for dinner. Maybe you'll be able to introduce me to someone.
Definitely.
That's the plan. We've got to get people out there, and we have to get them connected to each other.
Exactly.
It's the most important thing.
Connecting. I wish you both Hanukkah Sameach. And we'll be going out now with a little bit of latke music.
That's it.
And next week is going to be our last show for 2021. And then we're having a few weeks break, having a 4-week holiday over summer, which we always do. And we'll be showing repeats of the show. We might even do a best of if we can get our act together, because everyone's too busy. Wish you all the best. Shalom, shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom, shalom. Hanukkah Sameach. And we'll see you all around.
All right. Good luck.
All right. Zagazun.
So
be well.
Take care.
We'll see you next week for more Shtick. Few at a time. Few at a time. From one side, then the other. Until both are golden bright. Tonight is Hanukkah. Got everything we need. A frying pan, some more. For your latke recipe. Let's celebrate. Joy, celebration, a single jar that perforates the food we eat. As part of our tradition, it keeps that flame alive.